like, share, subscribe. HCB2World.
Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Or actually, should I say, welcome to the very first Halloween edition of Tuesday Tantrums. So, you know, with this being a special edition, I figured we do things a little differently. So tonight,
boy, you doing another one of these damn Tuesday Tantrum videos? You know anybody watching this shit, right? Don't nobody watch this shit. You ain't funny. That's why they're not watching. You ain't funny. Nobody enjoy these videos.
Oh, you got jokes, huh? You Mr. JoJo funny ass, huh?
You know what? You ought to be ashamed of yourself. Hey, listen, don't let them shake your confidence, all right? Don't let them shake your confidence. And as for you, I know your mom taught you better than that, okay? I know your mama taught you better than that.
My mama? Who's mama? You talking about my mama? Boy, I know you ain't talking about
here
my mama. Your mama up here looking like Celie from The Color Purple. Oh, shucking and jiving ass woman. Looking like you just came from a 2002 party at P. Diddy's. Boy, you better stop.
2002? P. Diddy's party? You know what, guy? Cut the malarkey, all right? Cut it out. First of all, I know you're not talking about what I'm wearing when you're out here. You look like the Great Value version of a junior deacon. Why don't you give a good sermon? You look like you just came back from the juke joint. You look like somebody's dirty uncle who's always drinking.
All right, listen, that's enough. Right, we gotta get the show done, all right? So listen, with this being the very first Halloween version of Tuesday Tantrums, you know, it's gonna be a lot of fun, so hopefully you guys enjoy it. This time we got me, and me, so we're gonna get this thing underway, you know? Other than that, no more time on the intro, let's go! All right, first tantrum. People who dress their pets up for Halloween. Stop, listen, before y'all even get mad, stop, all right? I get it. Some people don't have kids, you know? Some people don't have kids, and so the closest thing you can have to a kid is your pet. So yeah, maybe you treat your cat like one of your kids. Maybe you treat your dog like one of your kids. I get it, all right? For real, I really do get it. But what I don't get is why the hell your dog has to dress up for Halloween. Like, bro, like, why does your dog have to be Wonder Woman for Halloween? Why does your dog have to be Iron Man? You know, I understand maybe you want to take some pictures and, you know, you want to have the memories. I get that. To an extent, I get that. I don't have a problem with the picture. You want to dress your dog up real quick, take a picture, that's fine. But where the line is for me is when you're taking your dog around with a basket and you're actually going door to door trying to collect candy for this dog, all right? Like, I do not get that at all. One, I'm pretty sure sugar will wreck your animal. Two, I thought dogs couldn't have chocolate anyway. Why are you running around collecting candy for this animal, all right? Why are you doing it? Stop. You know better. Like, stop it. Stop doing it, okay? I mean, if you want to have a nice little scrapbook, you know, you want to get your little photos on, I'm good with that. What I'm not good with is you having your dog running around here dressed in all these outfits so you can collect candy, and then on top of that, your animal is scaring the kids. If it's a little dog, yeah, okay, I get it. But even then, your dog don't need candy. But if you're running around here with one of these big dogs, you're scaring the kids, you gotta stop. You know better. We shouldn't even be having this talk, all right? You know better. But you know, you're gonna justify it. Oh, that's my kid. Oh, you know, well, everyone else is taking their kids out, so why can't I? Because it's a dog! Stop!
It's been a while since I've been out. Let's see what kind of jokes we got. Here we go. What kind of music do mummies love? Rap music. Wait, what? What fruit do scarecrows love the most? Strawberry. Man, what in the hell? How do you fix a cracked pumpkin? A pumpkin patch. Oh my god. Why didn't a skeleton go to school? His heart wasn't in it. Boy, if this ain't some of the candy corniest shit I've ever seen. You know what? Throw the whole damn internet away. Throw the internet away. Throw the channel away. Fuck, just throw it all away, alright? Throw it all away.
Second tantrum. Parents who go out here on Halloween nights and just let their kids run all through the streets. Trust me, I get it. You know, it's a night for kids to have fun. It's a night for kids to get out, enjoy themselves, and really have a good time. But you gotta understand, man, there are some people out here that's treating residential areas like Grand Theft Auto, you know? Some people out here trying to get those 50 points. So you just can't be letting your kid run across the street without watching them. Then you got kids out here just bag snatching and throwing up and stuff. You ain't cleaning it up. Y'all gotta stop it, all right? We gotta do a better job of watching the kids, baby. And then, you know, sometimes I'm walking around the neighborhood and I see kids lost. They don't know where their parents are because maybe the parents are walking the kids and having a good drink, having a good old time. They turn their back, kids take off, right? You see the signs all the time. Kids dart. Kids dart. Sometimes your kid takes off, but you gotta know where your kid is going, all right? You gotta know where your kid's at. There's a lot of people out here snatching up kids. You just can't be doing whatever you want, you know? Having a good time drinking your apple cider or your wine or whatever the hell you got in your cup while your kid is running around the neighborhood. People snatch kids, all right? All it takes is one sicko to invite your kid in. You might not ever see little Tommy again. Got to use your think melon, parents. Got to use your think melon. And while we're on the subject, why are your parents walking around drinking anyway? There are a lot of parents out here treating Halloween like it's a pre-game tip-off where you can just go and sit and get your tailgate on while you walk the neighborhoods. You can't be walking out in public drunk. What's wrong with y'all? Huh? Where they do that at? Huh? Y'all gotta stop it. Y'all gotta stop it. You know who you are. Listen, I'm not judging. I get it. Sometimes, you know, kids drive you nuts. It's Halloween. It's a lot of kids running around. A lot of screaming. A lot of headache. Sometimes you just gotta unwind. But you can't do it while you're on the clock, baby. And when I say on the clock, yeah, granted, you're not working. But you're supposed to be watching your kid. You just can't get sauced while the kid is running the neighborhood. What you think? All these other parents are just volunteer babysitters? No, that's your job. You gotta pay attention to what you're doing, all right? You gotta pay attention. Not only what you're doing, what your kid's doing. You can't be letting your kid run around here and get their Dennis the Menace on. All right, you can't be letting your kids baby kidding out here on Halloween. This ain't a night off, it's a night on, baby. A night on. Pay attention to your kid. Don't let your kid get kidnapped. Don't let your kid eat too much candy. Clean it up if it throws up, all right? I said it. Last, but certainly not least, all right? Certainly not least. Have fun, baby. You know what I mean? Listen, we only get to do this once a year. Have fun. Take lots of pictures of your kids dressed up. Take lots of pictures of all the smiles, you know. Take pictures of them holding their basket. You know, the triumph. It's been a rough year. COVID has taken a lot, but don't let it take these memories from these kids. Now, with that being said, I'm saying have fun. But listen, parents, this is important now. If you're going to dress up, all right, let's be realistic. I get it. I said in my other video, Halloween is a holiday where you can be someone else, you know? You get to put that mask on, baby, and be someone else that you can't be the other 364 days of the year. But y'all gotta do it within reason, man, all right? Listen, you just can't be out here putting on costumes that don't fit. Like me, you don't see me wearing some costume with skinny dude. I'm a big guy. I'm kind of muscular. I'm a big guy, all right? You just don't see me putting on whatever I want. Gotta be selective on your outfits, parents. Listen, if it don't fit the other days, it's not going to fit on Halloween, no matter how much you try to squeeze it in there, all right? Let's be reasonable. And also, if you're going to do the whole family costume thing, don't be out here embarrassing these kids. Don't make your kid stop and take a picture with you every 5 minutes. It's embarrassing, all right? Does the kid mind that you guys are dressed the same? Maybe not. Some people like to dress up as the Incredibles. Some people want to go around dressed up as the Simpsons. And that's fine. But don't be embarrassing the kids in front of their friends. Y'all know that shit y'all do. You trying to take a picture, hit the kid with the old lick a finger, wipe whatever's on their face. Let them enjoy the night, all right? Let them enjoy the night. All right, you don't got to embarrass the kids like that. Now, I'm saying have fun, but you got to do it within reason. You know kids don't want to be embarrassed in front of their friends. If you want to take a picture, do it on the low. Not while all your kids got their friends looking at them. Because they're going to have to hear that shit on Monday, all right? They're going to have to hear it on Monday. You don't want your kid in the lunchroom being teased about having mom lick her thumb and wipe the crust off his face or the chocolate or whatever's on his face, you know? Like, be reasonable. And like I said, with these costumes, you got to be reasonable on that too, all right? You don't want your kid getting talking about your mom was out there trick-or-treating with you with that little-ass costume looking like melted ice cream. Kids don't recover from that. Listen. You've never sat at a lunch table and had your mom talk about it. The lunch table game is brutal. Do not give your kids enemies ammo for Monday because your kid is not going to come home happy. No one enjoys getting roasted at a lunch table. Is it a rite of passage? Absolutely. But most kids like to do the roasting. All right? Most kids don't like to be the ones getting roasted. Make good decisions, parents. All right? make good decisions, pay attention to your kids, pay attention to your surroundings, and have fun. All right?
Have fun.
All right, guys, that's going to do it for the very first Halloween version of Tuesday Tantrums. I had a lot of fun. I had a, you know, had some interesting guests today. Y'all seen some interesting stuff. It is what it is, all right? It is what it is. Hopefully you got to... Don't look at me like that. That's not a COVID cough, all right? It's not a COVID cough. That was a laughing cough. Y'all heard me laughing, all right? That's a laughing cough. Anyway, if you enjoyed the video, smash that like button for your boy, all right? If you enjoyed the video, hit that like button. If you're new to the channel and haven't been here before, go ahead and subscribe. Listen to me. I understand. This economy is not doing that great. Not everyone has a lot of money, but the good thing about subscribing is free, baby. Hit that free subscribe button. Check out the rest of my videos. Maybe you're not an anime person, but if you like to laugh, check out these Tuesday Tantrums videos, all right? Other than that, that's going to do it for HCB2 World. As always, I'm your boy, Heroes Come Back 2. Do great, be great. I'll catch you guys in the next video, all right? Peace!